and two away. It looks like we'll see a pinch hitter in this spot.
Now batting, the shortstop, Tim Roth.
Hopped up. Reyna is calling for it. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Lawrence Givens enters to do.
Now pitching for Sacramento.
This evening's game comes to an end. 5-4, the final tally. The Albuquerque Isotopes put up a four spot in the opening frame on the way to victory. Minor League Baseball is live.
Play ball. Out.
Into the box. Tim Roth. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on.
Roth.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Carmichael giving chase. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Now at the plate, Raimel Tapia. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. The 1-2 pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Scooped up. One there. On to Moreland, but it's too late, so they'll get just the one.
Play ball. Out. He's out. Three. Out. Three. You're out. That's ball four. Three.
Standing in, Tim Roth. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Tim Roth.
From the stretch. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time.
Find the ball. Find the ball.
But foul. Ready with the 0-1. Pulled toward right center field. Waiting on it is Tapia. And that retires the side. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. Striding into the box, Mike Tauchman. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Has a look, now the pitch. Little chopper up the middle, backhanded. And he thought about going to second, but he'll go to first instead. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the... Ready for another chance, Tim Roth. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. In the air now, out to left. Carmichael is after it. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. So coming to the plate, Alex Vila. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, big A last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. Just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
On to Moreland, and that's in time.
Three. You're out. Three.
Ready for another shot now, Tim Roth, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Into right field, that's a base hit. And they will hold that possible tying run at third, as even with two away, they decide to put the stop sign on.
Now batting,
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Mitch Moreland, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. Digging in, Raimel Tapia. He's working here to bring home that very important insurance run, standing at third. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. Galvis is there, and the side is retired. Digging in and looking for more, Tim Roth. He'll try and lead things off here in inning number nine. Ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Boy, he just looks locked in at the plate right now to me. His numbers in recent games have been very good, and those were two stone-cold takes right there that put himself in a great hitter's count.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. But that'll be off the wall in right center. The relay, the throw pulls him off the bag.
Wow, he was willing that thing to get out of here. Would have given them the lead right here late in the game, but it ends up hitting off the wall, and he heads into second with an extra base hit. We'll see if the next man up can come through in the clutch here.
Here's the first baseman now, Mitch Moreland, and he could very well get the intentional pass here, as that would set up a potential double play ball that might keep the game tied. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Yeah, the guy's been on fire lately, hitting anything close. So I think this is the way to go here. Get the bat out of his hands any way that you can.
Now batting, Stephen Vogt. Two hits in four attempts to this point. The 0-1 lifted in the air out towards left center. On the run is Tapia. He gets there and makes the play for the first down. In now, Dylan Cousins. Couple of singles for him in four trips for him this afternoon.
Dylan Cousins.
Now the 0-2 pitch. Hit hard towards center. And that is down for extra bases. Is that on a plate to go-ahead run and maybe another? And he's in there safely as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
Talk about putting an exclamation point at a game. Wow. Game tied the ninth, man on base, and he attacks the baseball, driving in the go-ahead run and landing at third along the way. And now he's 90 feet away from padding that.
Trying to pick things up where we left off, Tim Roth. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Wall. Up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making.
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side.
Hey, a great win for these guys as they wrap up another one. But a little bit of a sour note, though. Everyone has to head home, get on those computers, and get those taxes out before midnight.
And we're going to have a pinch hitter to start things out here in the top half of the inning.
Leading off for Sacramento, the shortstop, Tim Roth.
And he gets ahead 0-1. That batting average, boy, pushing very close to 400. One home run, nine driven in. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And that's a base hit into center field.
Not a swing right you can't there. Ask for anything more than getting a leadoff man on right there. It brings the go-ahead run to the plate. He's in position to do some damage. It'd be interesting to see how the manager plays this one.
The batter number one, second baseman, Phillip Rainey.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really important time for a strikeout there, guys. Tying run at first, so objective number one is stranding him on base. And now with one out, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that run.
The center fielder, number four, Bruce Wayne Schmidt.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
The right fielder, number three, Rob.
In now, McMahon. Rob McMahon. Pitch outside. The throw is not close as he's in there with a stolen base.
This catcher's not known for his throwing ability, so you compound that with a big lead at first base. He had no chance to throw that runner out at second.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Fooled him with that one as he's way out in front. Runner breaks for third.
Come on, come on, come on.
Left field and deep. Carrillo racing back. A leap, but he can't get it. It's off the wall. And that's going to plate the tying run from second, and we are all even at five aside.
You know, D-Row, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late inning, so that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in the bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws on there.
Four, take the base, three.
A tight one, 7-6, the final score tonight. Sacramento used a three-run seventh to help propel them to the win. Doug Cordero earns his third win of the year in relief. Kyle Crockett records the save, his ninth of the year. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. Every game has its offensive stars, and in this one, he arguably shined the brightest. He's our top player of the game.
Fans are
yeah, he
final
came through with
score.
A multi-hit
First
game, and more importantly,
now on your home for minor league baseball. MLB The Show has coverage from the AAA Pacific Coast League. Tonight it's the first of four between the Sacramento River Cats and the Salt Lake Bees. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Henry Quevedo, the Cuban-born southpaw, gets the starting nod. What do we need to know here, Danny?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through the stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub-1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch.
Coming to the plate now, Tim Roth. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Here's the first pitch to him. Grounded down the third baseline. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Fellas are home nine as they begin play here this evening. It was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
Yeah, Maddie, what I need to see out of this offense today is some early production. Somebody's got to get on base and put the defense on their heels. They've been struggling recently. They're not swinging the bats well. They got shut out yesterday, and this offense needs to adjust itself.
Line towards center field. Catch made out there in center field as the runner will tag from second. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. And with that, here's a look at the visitor's starting lineup. D-Row, what do you got on this lineup in the series opener?
Matty, this lineup is built on one thing, and that's moving the ball over the fence. This is a station-to-station team. Not a lot of speed in this lineup, but they don't need much speed when they're moving traffic to both gaps.
Into the box now, Tim Roth.
Now batting, shortstop, Tim.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Takes this the other way to right. Merritt is there, one away.
Play ball. Three.
Next will be the designated hitter, Aaron Kramer. He's looking to extend that hitting streak, which stands at eight games coming in. Slow roller out to short. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Make it nine straight here to start the. So here's the cleanup hitter, Guy Forbes, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Line drive, fair ball down the line.
Relay.
And to score from third, the tying run.
Play ball. You're
out. At the plate, Tim Roth.
Now batting, shortstop.
Here comes the first pitch.
Roth.
Line drive to center field, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Hey, guys, there had to be something in the scouting report right there. For him to be on top of that 0-0 changeup the way he was, that was pretty special.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Greg Bird. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Greg Bird.
Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
Ready now, Yonhervis Solarte. No hits to this point.
Third baseman, Yonhervis Solarte.
Now a snap move over to first. And a dive, but he's back. Roth leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Runners off for second. Swing and he pops him up. Merritt moving in. He can't get to it. This one's down.
Boy, not the prettiest of swings, D-Row. That looked a little bit from the Vladimir Guerrero book, but nonetheless, he got the job done.
Yeah, a little choke and poke right there. He flipped a bat out there and was able to find a little empty green grass. Not pretty, but he'll take it.
Striding forward now is the DH, Freddy Galvis. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch.
Galvis.
Try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. So it's no runs on two hits. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Johnny Dias. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. The 0-1. On the ground is short. Could be two. Cleanly in time to first, and there are two away.
Let's play ball. That's ball four.
Now at the plate, Tim Roth. He singled his last time up. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the... This is line to left. And that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit. In to score, the runner from third. And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And up next will be the left-handed power bat of Greg Bird. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Green has a beat on it. And that's the third out. So three runs on four hits, no errors, and a man left on. The 5, 6, and 7 slots due up in the bottom of inning number six. And we are tied 4-4. Stepping up to the plate, Hubert Spencer coming off the clutch two-run single his last time up.
Spencer.
A one pitch on its way. Offliner towards first. Oh, and he misses it. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there.
Let's play ball. Ball four. Thank you, man.
So striding in, Tim Roth, and their runners at the corners now. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. This is driven to right, and no doubt about it, that one's way out of here. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. And just like that, this ball game is all tied.
Well, when it left its bat, I didn't think it had the height to even clear the fence. Shows you how much I know. That thing was a laser shot that just kept going and going and going. Wow, that was impressive.
Play ball. Out. Three. Got him. Out. He's safe. That's ball four. He's out. Out. Three.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
A one-run finish, an 8-7 game tonight. The Rivercats crossed the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Dan Haney gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Kyle Crockett closes the door for the save, his 10th. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score. First for the victorious Rivercats, 8 runs on 15 hits, no errors.
There is rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started. Tonight, the second of four between the Sacramento Rivercats and the Salt Lake Bees. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Justin Napier, the southpaw out of the Golden State, gets the call here. What's your take on him, Dan?
Boy, it's been a rough go for this guy, Matt, in his last three starts. Last three starts, he's taken the loss in all three. So he'd like to turn that fortune around in this one today. And the best way to start that, throw up a zero in the first inning.
Striding in, Tim Roth, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
Tim Roth.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one. Fellas, you take a look at our homestanding ball club as they come into this one tonight. It was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Row, talk about a team that's scuffling right now. I had a chance to talk to the manager before the game. He's not happy. The players aren't happy.
Yeah, and just a malaise has kind of come over this clubhouse. We had a chance, like you said, to walk through it a little bit. The boys are not jumping around. This is a big game today.
Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Got him to chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice pitch, and it can be a really tough one to lay off of.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And this will kick off the base of the wall. Slater ignores his coach. He's chugging for home. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving that teammates in the dugout.
The first baseman, Mitch Moreland.
Driven to deep right field. Hermosillo going back on it. On the warning track, he makes
the catch.
The relay throw, and he'll go ahead and take third on the fly ball to right, so he's 90 feet away now with two men gone. And now we'll look at the starting lineup for the visitors in this one. What's the key for them tonight, D-Ro?
Well, Matt, the key for me to success for this lineup is they got to be willing to come through in big spots. They got to stick to the game plan. Somebody's going to have to get a knock with two outs and find a way to not leave base runners stranded.
Coming to the plate now, Yonhervis Solarte. He's got that average way up into the 330s to begin the day.
It's still early in the season, but I'm not surprised to see this guy off to such a hot start, known as one of the better hitters in all the minor leagues.
3-0 now. Three balls, no strikes. Swinging a soft liner. Throw in time, and the side is retired. It's a run on two hits, one left. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. Sacramento leads this one, 1-0. So striding forward now, Michael Kuhl. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Michael.
Here's the payoff pitch.
This is slowly hit to short.
Probably too slowly to get two. Return throw is in time. How about that? They do turn two, and it gets him out of the... Stepping in and ready for another shot, Tim Roth. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Now a look and a throwback to second. Don't want to forget about him. Comes set with the 0-1. Started the breaking ball far too inside that time. Laid off for ball one. And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
You chase a pitch that bad outside the zone, you got to find a way to regroup, adjust the batting gloves, only look over the heart of those seven.
No, that's just low. A bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
A lot of times you see guys in the middle of the order get worked away, but not right here. They're keeping it inside on him.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended?
I think that's the idea, Matt, but he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
Full count now. Working for the punch out and the offering. Swing and a miss at the curveball, and there's your second out of the inning. So stepping in, Michael Koo, 0-1 for him here in this one.
Michael.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. A bouncer to the left side, reined in, and he's safe.
You know, D-Row, sometimes one of your best friends, D-Row.
Digging in the switch hitter, Hubert Spencer. He flew out in his last at bat.
Spencer.
Here now the 2-2. Swung on and grounded towards short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Digging in once again, Tim Roth. 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. First pitch of the at-bat. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. Runners at the corners, two men out. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Moving under it, Koo. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Digging in, Taylor Ward. A hit and two tries so far.
Number three.
Here's the 0-2. There's a line drive, base hit to left field.
Play ball. Three. That hit him. First base. He's out.
Now to the plate, Tim Roth.
Now batting, the shortstop.
First delivery to him on the way.
Roth.
Line towards center field. And he will run this one down, moving to his left, and that's the second out of the inning.
Three. 4-4. Take your break. Out. You're out. Three. He's safe. Three.
And guys, a very important outing turned in on the mound for the man you see right there. He was a big factor, of course, and is the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award. Welcome to MLB The Show and this presentation of Minor League Baseball. Today, Game 3 of this four-game series between the Sacramento RiverCats and the Salt Lake Bees. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Taylor Cole, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy's a fun guy to watch pitch. Not necessarily an overpowering guy. Has an ERA in the low threes. But one thing he knows how to do, he knows how to pitch, and he knows how to minimize damage. If you're going to have an ERA...
At the plate, Tim Roth. He drove in one of their two runs in last night's ball game. First pitch coming. Here it is. Didn't threaten the zone there. Looked like it might have actually popped out of his hand a little early. Dan, D-Ro, we take a look at our home nine as they take the field here today. Well, they've come in losers of 7 of their last 10 games, but did earn the victory last time out.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Ro, this has not been the kind of homestand that they would like to have so far. Through the first 5 games, they're 2-3. D-Ro, getting to 500 on this homestand is certainly one thing they'd like D-Ro. To do here today.
Yeah, they can salvage a little bit right now. They can walk out of here today with a smile on their face if they can get this back to 500 in these first 6 games.
Good change up in the dirt, strike 3, and the throw to first is there to record the second out. Time now to give you a look at the batting order for the visiting squad. Mark DeRosa, what's your take on him this afternoon on the road?
Matty, this is going to be a fun lineup for me to watch. I get fired up watching these guys because they all have a plan. It works for them. They follow the scouting reports. They grind it out in the video room. I'm interested to see what they've come up with.
Three.
Striding in once again, Tim Roth. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
The windup and the 0-1 to first.
Come on, get here.
And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Play ball. Ball four. Take the ball.
Stepping in, Taylor Ward. He flew out in his last at
number
bat.
Number 3.
Two.
The second, could be two. He's right there. On to Moreland, and it's a double play.
Play ball. That's ball four.
Now at the plate, Tim Roth. Already the beginning of the seventh inning here, as this game has had a very brisk pace to it so far. The pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Fly ball out toward left center field. Koo is in retreat as he pulls it in for the first out.
Three. Out. You're out. Three. 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 He's out. Out. You're out.
Standing in, Tim Roth.
Now batting. The shortstop.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. Weak grounder back to the mound.
Dig.
On to first, and they're an out away. Two gone here in the ninth.
Play ball.
A 2-0 finish today. The Bees took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. MLB The Show's tour of the minor leagues continues as we make a stop in the 16-team Pacific Coast League. Today it's the finale of this 4-game set between the Sacramento Rivercats and the Salt Lake Bees. It's baseball. It's The Show, and it comes your way next. J.C. Ramirez gets handed the ball for the fourth and final game of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matt, this guy keeps his team in the ballgame. He's won two of his last three starts, so he's been throwing the ball really well. And one of the keys for this guy is getting early outs to keep his pitch count down. If he can do that, he should be able to get into the seventh or eighth inning in this one here today.
Into the box now, Tim Roth. Hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday. Here comes the first pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle to second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So digging in now, Aaron Kramer, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. This is on the ground over to first. To second. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Digging in to try it again, Tim Roth. 0-for-1 here in the early going. First delivery to him on the way. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he pushed it just a bit too much. It'll wind up a foul ball. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Ready on 0-2. Off the plate at 94, 1-2.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to take. 0-2 fastball just off the corner, and I mean just off the corner.
Oh, double play ball to second.
Move it.
The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step. Stepping up now, Mitch Moreland. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
Hermosillo will drift over to his left a few steps as he takes it for the second out. At the plate, Guy Forbes, he came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a one hit in your entire career. Now, maybe he gets hot.
Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Ready once again, Tim Roth, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
Really doesn't matter which side of the plate this guy bats from. He hits very well. He hits right-handed pitching very well, swinging left-handed, and swinging from the right side against lefties. The numbers are quite the same. This guy flat out can hit from either side.
That misses 2-0.
Boy, he just looks locked in at the plate right now to me. His numbers in recent games have been very good, and those were two stone-cold takes right there that put himself in a great hitter's count.
And again a throw, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. McMahon, the runner at first, with two gone. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. Foul.
Oh, that's foul.
To 2-2 now.
Just reached back and threw a high fastball right by him. He didn't stand a chance.
Here now the 2-2. And he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. Koo ranging back. To the track, to the wall, and off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field. Two-run shot to straightaway center. Home run number 3 here in the early going, as it's now a 4-1 ball game.
Everybody loves to get on a good piece of cheese, hit a fastball out of the yard. But I tell you what, to be able to stay back and take a curveball deep, it's one of those special feelings when you can wreck.
Take his hacks again, Tim Roth, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up.
And going back to that previous at-bat when he hit the two-strike breaking ball for a home run, something tells me that this guy, when he gets behind in the count, sits on something off-speed or the breaking ball.
Swing and he pops him up. Ward in foul ground, and no one will track it down. A pause and the 0-2 lifted the other way out to left center, calling for it, Green, and that ends the inning. Stepping into the box, Travis Green, already two for two. He'll look to add on right here.
Travis.
Hit out towards short. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. We'll see the left-handed bat of Mitch Moreland lead things off when we return. Seventh inning coming up. The River Cats lead it 8-1. Now in the box, Tim Roth. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Tim.
That's lifted the other way out to left. Green is in his tracks now as he makes the catch.
Three. That's ball four.
Your attention, please.
Stepping in, Guy Forbes, eighth batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and two away.
Guy.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you can coast to a six-run win. Save your closer for another day and let it go.